Good morning, and welcome to the online service of the Unitarian Church of Montreal. We are very happy to have you here with us today. Bonjour et bienvenue au service virtuel de l'Église Unitarienne de Montréal. Nous sommes très contents de vous avoir parmi nous aujourd'hui. My name is Brian Vidal, and my pronouns are he and him. We begin our service today by acknowledging our presence on the traditional lands of the First Nations. Our church and myself are on the unceded territory of the Kanyegahaga Nation. We call it unceded because it was taken without treaty or agreement. Our congregation is committed to the journey towards reconciliation to the indigenous people of this land. Today, I want to light our chalice, the symbol of our faith and hope, and share a story about grief and reconciliation. In the book Indian Horse by Richard Wagamese, six-year-old Saul Indian Horse, an Ojibwe boy, is forced into a residential school where he witnessed an infinite range of physical, verbal, and sexual abuse. Even though the book is a work of fiction, it displays a horrific and very real chapter in Indigenous history in Canada. So, how can we understand the grief of survivors and work towards reconciliation when it comes to the atrocities committed to First Nations in the residential school system? Education has always been the key. That's why the Indian Horse book has promoted a challenge called The Next 150 Days, a place where people are encouraged to listen and watch and read and share, and most importantly, never forget the survivors of the Indian residential schools. You can access the website next150.indianhorse.ca to know more about the next 150 challenge. And with this message about being aware of the grief sustained by the residential school system survivors and the path to reconciliation, we light our chalice. Welcome.